I've actually known President Simmons a lot longer than this evening. In 2001, Brown University, my alma mater, was going through a really shocking period. It was a shocking period because a president who was well-liked, well-respected, had decided to step down to go to another institution. It was something that just doesn't happen to the school. The alumni and certainly the student body were stunned. They were just adrift and weren't really sure what to make of it. A search committee was formed, and in 2001, Ruth Simmons was named the president of Brown University. Now, one of the interesting things about President Simmons is, at least as I started to learn about her, is why do you hire a sharecropper's daughter? She's the youngest of 12. She is somebody who grew up in a society, Houston, Texas. She left Grapeland, Texas, where her father and mother sharecropped, to move to Houston. She was lived in the Fifth Ward, poverty-stricken. It was poor. But one of the things you're going to learn about President Simmons when you meet her tonight is she is just someone who doesn't take no, won't be denied. So why do you hire a sharecropper's daughter? She's the first person from her family to attend college. She attended Dillard. And after graduating from Dillard's magna cum laude, she became one of you. She's a Fulbrighter. She went to the University of Lyon in France, where she studied French. Now, just a reminder, she's up here, she actually went to Dillard on a drama scholarship. So she's got a little acting in her. But she is fluent in French, and French is what she loves and what she does. And you hire a sharecropper's daughter because when you tell her she can't go to college, not only does she go, but she excels. She becomes a Fulbrighter. And not only does she become a Fulbrighter, but in just recently, 2002, she was given an award only shared by very few, one of them being the composer Philip Glass, another one the historian John Hope Franklin. She was given the medal for lifetime achievement for a Fulbrighter. You hire a sharecropper's daughter because after taking some academic posts, I'm sure most of you are familiar with her background, but she became the first African-American to lead a major U.S. university when she was named the president in 1995 of the largest women's college in the United States, Smith College. So why do you hire a sharecropper's daughter? Because she turned Smith into something that it wanted to be. And so when Brown University in 2001 was looking for its president, it did what Brown graduates have done, at least the men, for years and years. It went to Smith. And there, what President Simmons has done is she has raised the level there. She has been a tireless and very impressive fundraiser. Boldly Brown is her initiative, $1.4 billion. The medical school named with a $100 million gift. A $120 million gift to go along with that. She has also made Brown come to grips with some of its past, letting the university understand that it was slavery that it was built on, and we need to deal with that. And so in 2003, she appointed a steering committee, and they issued a report. But she makes Brown look forward. She understands what education means. She understands what international exchanges mean. Not only is she a Fulbrighter, but she has pushed Brown University into the international arena. And just this March, she was in India for a program that has the Brown community start to understand the Indian culture. You hire a sharecropper's daughter because she is one of the best university presidents in the United States today. She is the first African-American woman to lead an Ivy League institution. Ladies and gentlemen, she has a lot to tell us. We have a lot to learn. I think this is going to be a great evening and a terrific speech. And I hope you all will help me welcome the 18th president of Brown University, Ms. Ruth J. Simmons. Dr. Ruth J. Simmons. I saw you looking at your watch.
Thank you. All right.